One Belt, One Road is a dream project of China. This route connects the China to Western countries of Pakistan. It is a difficult task for China to complete this dream project. In this route, Uzbekistan, Ukraine and Greece and other roads of small states have been existed. All states have own geographic, political and social terms and conditions which are difficult for China to tackle these issues. That's why China have focused more on CPEC. CPEC is the project of China and Pakistan, and through CPEC, Pakistan will connect the China all over the world. Karakoram Highway is the 800-mile structure road built by China and Pakistan, and it is the main trade route. £11 billion trade have been taken place through this route. In return, Karakoram Highway gives the direct and smooth access to Gwadar Port on Pakistan coast. It developed the Gwadar Port and modernized the Gwadar structure and developed the Gwadar Port like Dubai in future. That's why it is the game changer for Pakistan economy. China invest roads of amount on CPEC, and it is around $46 billion which may be raised in future. You can look that map. China economy mostly depend on import and export of Middle East and European countries. For this, China use the sea route, which have almost the distance around 13,000 kilometers. And China pay roads of taxes to other countries like Vietnam, Sri Lanka and Taiwan. After the completion of CPEC, this distance compressed into 2,000 to 3,500 kilometers. This is the land route of Pakistan. China will get the benefit around $2 billion annually. The geographical location of Gwadar Port is main determinant for shining Pakistan. Gwadar is closest to Iran and other Middle East countries. It is almost 8 to 10 days route for Gwadar to China after the completion of CPEC. Other countries like Russia also use the CPEC route to access the Middle East countries. China access to world European country through CPEC. What are the route of CPEC in Pakistan? Rebuild heavy structure Karakoram Highway across Karakoram Mountain and Hindu Kush in Pakistan. The Karakoram Highway based on tunnels and smooth road which connect with Gilgit-Baltistan. There are two main routes of CPEC. First is Balochistan to Gwadar route, which connect the CPEC from Gilgit-Baltistan to Peshawar and then Quetta, and finally through Balochistan this route finished on its destiny, Gwadar Port. Second route is Punjab to Sindh route, and this route consists of M2 motorway Islamabad to Rohol, and this motorway extended from Rohol to Karachi through CPEC project. From Karachi to Gwadar there is already existing highway, that is Mehran Coastal Highway. After access on Gwadar, China connect with Iran easily and with very low cost, because during all CPEC route China only paid taxes to Pakistan and go forward to Middle East countries for import and export purpose. CPEC is not the trade route. It solves other many issues of Pakistan in context of infrastructure, power issue, development of Gwadar Port. Life is about change. With CPEC, especially near the village of Neelam Jhelum River. Electricity generating project under constructing with start capacity 9,063 kilowatt. which is highest hydropower plant in Pakistan. Second largest underground terminal project in Asia is also the project of CPEC, which length is around 70 km and takes the train complete distance in 40 minutes. And this terminal is 10 km long. Neelam Jehlam largest overseas hydropower project is taken by Chinese company and it's completed in 2017. Which have the capability to provide 500 million kilowatt electricity to Pakistan. This project is the beam of light in dark, whitening the future of Pakistan. The Pakistan South Coast Power Station is under construction and it is Port Qasim coal fired plant which generates 95 billion kilowatt hour annually. This project is the key part of CPEC, cover the cost around 2 billion. It is in the hand of Pakistan that how much Pakistan get the benefit through CPEC. It become the opportunity or threat as well. It is based on Pakistan political, army and bureaucracy action that how they avail maximum benefit from CPEC. No doubt there are some fears such as the China involvement will be increased in Pakistan. It is the question mark on our sovereignty. Majority amount of this project China give on long term loan. China is entrapping Pakistan by giving expensive loan and credit for project of dubious economic value. If it is able to repay, China will take off the Gwadar port land asset in Pakistan if Pakistan is not able to repay, as they have done in case of Hambantota port in Sri Lanka. This is the biggest example of China nefarious intention to colonize poor countries. In order to realize these opportunities and mitigate the risk, the government of Pakistan has to take several policy and institutional reforms and streamline its bureaucratic process. In absence of these measures, the benefit may turn out to be lower than what we have calculated and risk may be increased. It is in our hand that CPEC is the opportunity or threat for Pakistan.